Gato to you, filho.
You mother.
It's their biggest gamble yet.
Go wild, guys, baby. Let's get that oil.
The stakes have never been higher.
If we don't hit, I don't know how many millions, but it's going to be a huge loss for you.
We need to hit this one.
She's got a gun.
She's got a gun.
Now, one angry rancher.
Take this rig and get the hell out of here.
Can put a stop to it.
They're going to respect me or they can get the f*** out.
And all hell is about to break loose.
Get out of here! Get out of here! Get out of here!
The pressure is building.
Good, I'm good.
I'll whip your bitch ass.
You better go, boy.
All for a taste.
Love it. Love it. Want some more of it.
Of black gold. Gold.
This is going to be my first day drilling, baby.
Damn, y'all hurry.
While rookie driller Ben Green struggled.
This kind of can cost me my job.
That's a damn blind leading the blind.
Brandon let him down.
I just f***ed up.
It sucked.
Tank's personal life.
Love is f***ed up. Love is f***ed up.
You know we're soulmates.
Put him over the edge.
Chestnuts.
And Freddie hit his favorite target.
I'm going to cut your ass loose, son of a bitch.
Pushed to the limit by their bosses.
Get it on! Damn! Come on, Emmett.
Hey, Doug, stop bumping them sweet!
The Roughnecks of Rig 28 are into their second week of Wildcat.
Oh, let's go, let's go!
And they haven't found a drop of oil.
It's just a lot of that we need to get done. I was told today just run on them like they're red-headed stepchildren.
Freddie Moore is feeling the squeeze from Big Dog Management.
And get it straight, get it fixed. Freddie may be looking for a job.
And he knows landowner Peggy Hauser could show up at any moment.
I'm tired of coming out here. Are we clear?
So the veteran tool pusher is going to whip the rig into shape.
I'm going to have hands out here and want to work and stay busy and get the done that we need to get done. Hey, pile it up underneath there so they can't come back this way. Y'all start up at the top on one side or the other where it's dirty at.
Hey, Ben?
Yes, sir?
You see this right here? See this list right here? This is the list, and I want to get this done. I'm sitting here dead in the water. Get them damn hands on this list. You're their leader.
Yes, sir.
Make him damn do this list.
To-do list in hand and a supervisor promotion in his sights, Freddie wants to make himself and Rig 28 look good.
Make it shine like a diamond in a goat's ass. Make us all look good.
But for the hands, Freddie's list is pure punishment.
Doing Freddie's list? You don't have to yell at us. You can ask us nicely.
That!
Dude, you don't have to get all rude about it.
Freddie runs this rig like a third world dictator.
He can go back to his trailer. I'm tired of Freddie already today.
Hey! Don't cut no more yet till we get this pumped down. Still filling it up?
Start filling it up again? What you said, start filling it up.
I said, are you still filling it up?
I'm pumping it over.
We don't want to pump it over.
You just told me when to get it pumped. When I get it made up, pump it over.
I want it as full as we can get it because that's all the drill we had.
It was full.
Huh? Don't go up to me, buddy.
I'm not, ready. I'm not, Freddie. But you told me to get it built up and pump it over.
You ain't got to rent it if you ain't going.
This time, Brandon's got a point.
Freddy's a kid, man.
He's doing exactly what Freddie told him to.
He wants to go
come up here and tell me to do it when I'm doing it after you done told me three times.
Bullshit. I shouldn't have to sit on these pits with these damn experienced Derek, man.
Cross that line, you bastard mother.
I whoop his fat ass.
How the is he gonna tell me that when he done told me to do what I'm doing? I don't give a say what he wants to say.
He can.
Get them damn glasses on your face. You have to have your out.
All right, man. Why you gotta yell at me, Freddy?
Damn.
He can go back to sleep for all I care.
Brandon don't quit bowing up to me every time I tell him to do something. Get his ass butt hurt every time you say something to him. Act like he's the badass out here. I'll send him to the house.
Below the mud house.
They're gonna get your asses in that sub, scrub. They're gonna clean up, pick up.
Though Cheston's been sentenced to hard labor.
I'd rather be in here scrubbing than out there scrubbing. That heat'll wear you out.
As usual, the worm thinks he's outsmarted the old tool pusher.
When he said, get down there in that sub, scrub, I said, yes, sir. Get that draft of cool wind through this tunnel through here. Now keep cool. Hey, walk around this to-do list. He just pulled a crap.
The worm still doesn't understand the basic rules of the rig. Keep your mouth shut.
Freddy gets on my nerves when he's on his little warpath.
And keep your safety glasses on.
Oh, hell no. Hey!
Cheston, I'm gonna write you up for not wearing them glasses.
Got me. I ain't gonna put up with this.
The day grows hotter. Freddy's list gets longer.
Hey! There's one right there. Hook him up.
You ain't gonna run people like crazy, especially out in this heat. Everybody's gonna go, y'all go find somewhere else.
As work slows to a crawl,
you got a couple of them out here right now walking around like they just don't give a f***.
The tool pusher's frustration builds.
They don't want to work out here, don't make a f*** to me, they got a job.
And that's bad news for Cheston, who's got to face Freddy's iron fist at the end of the shift.
Freddy's on a warpath right now, and all we can do is say yes, sir. That's the best way to deal with it is say yes, sir, I'll do better. One ride up, don't kill nothing, and just roll with it. And don't let him catch you again.
This kind of roughneck common sense doesn't come easily to Cheston.
This will be my first ride up. Get ridden up too many times to get run off, so I think you're allowed four.
After the hand slacked off on his list, it's not a good time to be facing Freddy.
You're getting a verbal and a written warning, and I catch you one more time, I'm running your ass off. You can't follow.
I'm gonna run off, and I get four ride-ups. It's my first ride-up from my safety class.
And you're gonna have two of them. You're gonna have two today. A verbal and a written. One more, you're gone. I'm not telling you every day to wear them glasses. You know, as an employee out here, that you have to wear your glasses.
There's no excuse. I mean, I know you've told me before, but I mean, I literally just had finished scrubbing the whole entire sub that I was supposed to do today.
That's not.
I took them off and I looked at the work. You turned around and there you were. I mean,
you were scrubbing hours. When I looked at you, son. I was in the back of the sub, looking down through the sub. And you was hanging onto a beam, scrubbing.
It's the last piece that I missed. I was like, I looked at it and I scrubbed it. I was like, okay.
If you can't see through your glasses, clean them off. You either can agree or disagree on what I said. And you can sign it and date it. I'm not gonna get run off because you don't wear your glasses. I'd rather run you off and keep my job. That's just the way I see it. You know, faces are going to change, but mine probably ain't going to be one of them. I've seen a lot of people come and a lot of people go, but I'm still here. Joker. They don't want to follow the rules. I'm going to write them up. After so many of them write-ups, it's going to be bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Coming up.
Let go!
Paul Roughneck is out of sight.
I don't know if he has a job still.
And maybe out of a job.
This is it. I will run you off.
And later.
Bitch!
Mother off my Miracle Whip.
I can't apologize about a can of Miracle Whip, fool.
Worse than a woman.
Damn!
The red Texas dawn means bad weather's on the way.
Way to start the morning, baby. Way to start the morning.
But a storm's already brewing on the rig.
What's up, man?
Big tank up this morning. I sat outside for like 15 minutes. Finally, his wife called and said, he's not coming.
Tank's a no-show.
He can't handle this. He shouldn't be out here.
And he's let the day crew down.
I'm tired as hell, too.
He ain't no better than you. He ain't no better than me. This ain't making a hand, you know, sitting at home. I get another hand any given time.
All right, man.
It just pisses me off that, you know, a mother thing that they could take more time to themselves, you know what I'm saying? If you want to work, you come out here and work for me, you better get ready to work. I don't give a if you're 80 years old. You're my dad, you're my grandpa. I don't give a who you are. You better get your ass out here and work your ass.
Yeah, it pretty much pissed me off this morning. You know, I could have stayed in bed or something this morning for a little longer. Instead, I had to sit over there and wait on his ass.
Lately, Tank's lack of focus. Is frustrating Josh.
Tank, that guy can't ever done this before.
And everyone else on the rig.
I catch you on that cell phone again. Your ass is gonna be gone from here.
Better not find out you're on the phone. No, we're on this rig.
Pretty sure Austin's gonna run his ass off, man. Out here, you don't miss for. I mean, unless you have surgery or something like that, you don't miss work in the oil field, man.
On Interstate 20,
Josh thinks I'm fired.
Jen is headed to an emergency test at her doctor's.
I'm really nervous.
I know, baby.
The only thing that matters is you. You're my world, so.
Tank's putting his personal life ahead of his job.
I appreciate everything you do for us. I hope you know that.
Thank you.
Hey, pick it up a little.
Yeah.
That's good.
With just 6 weeks to drill Wildcat holes, the Roughnecks can't afford any setbacks.
The tank ran out of gas and got to find some gas somewhere else.
Especially being a man down.
I don't know if he has a job still. I mean, you got to be dependable. I mean, stomach ache, headache, because this rig has to go 24-7.
I really don't know what the deal is, but I mean, when you're a man down drilling a well, I mean, it just puts that much more work on everybody else.
Watch the cable! Watch the cable!
You gotta man up, be the man and be out here, you know? I don't care how good of a hand you are, if you're not here, you're not a very damn good hand.
Bad news spreads fast, so Jerry Chansey is headed to the rig. To check up on Freddie Moore, his competition for the supervisor promotion.
Good morning, Freddie.
We got her going?
Yeah.
The surprise visit puts Freddie on edge.
What about our hand situation? Who all showed up and who didn't?
The only one did show up today was Tank. I don't know what happened to him. Josh come in this morning and he said that Tank wasn't with him. That's the only thing I know about it. We done give him that second chance, and it's kind of like, he don't care, why should we care? But hell, I don't like to run off nobody unless I have to. You know, I know you probably feel different about it, but.
Yeah, because I like to run them off.
Tank's just another subject the veteran tool pushers don't agree on.
If his mama didn't die, I'm gonna farm. if Mama did die, I'd probably go fire him anyway.
As the evening shift arrives, so does a vicious storm.
Lightning's getting pretty close.
Clouds are moving.
In the oil field.
See that lightning out on the horizon? I don't want that storm heading this way.
Working against the elements makes the job that much harder.
It's gonna start raining again here in a minute.
Rookie driller Ben Green knows he's already behind. Day shift couldn't keep pace without Tank, and now he's running a rain-slicked rig.
It's cold out here, man. When it gets that cold and rainy, you gotta do everything you can in order to stay dry.
Definitely miserable out here, but what can you do? Getting paid, though, to be miserable, I guess. It's raining hell right now.
You gotta adjust to the environment, you know, the weather. It sucks, man.
The brakes get wet, they can't stop that drone from spinning 280,000 pounds down there right now. That's a hell of a lot of weight to try to stop. If your brakes get wet, you're in trouble.
Even though the rain makes everything more dangerous.
Hey, can I use a sick day today? I don't think we get sick days.
Ben and his roughnecks drill through the West Texas dirt. As the storm builds,
I want to see what happens when lightning hits this place.
Lightning takes its toll. And later,
part of why he was gone was my fault. I've had a medical issue and I needed him to be there with me.
Why don't you get a doctor?
There are thunderstorms.
Bad ass there ain't though.
And then there are West Texas thunderstorms.
Days like this, it sucks.
Did it hail yet?
Not yet, but it's coming down pretty hard.
Even when it's raining, thundering, lightning, tornado, whatever, we don't get no break.
As lightning strikes around them, James and his graveyard crew continue to make connections.
Yes, sir.
We had a real bad lightning hit.
A nearby site was hit and gives Freddie a call to warn him. Just 4 miles away.
Guys, you got to move back.
A nearby well suffered a direct lightning strike, igniting the oil storage tanks, burning at over 2,000 degrees. The blaze is hot enough to melt steel. Though no lives were lost, 27,000 gallons of oil have gone up in smoke, and 4 whole tanks have burned to the ground.
This isn't the first time, this ain't gonna be the last time. That's why we call it the act of God. Lightning's gonna hit, and there's nothing you can do to deter it.
News of the fire spread to the rig.
Pray to God it wouldn't get struck.
See how to the lightning bolt?
And the Roughnecks are starting to worry.
I want to see what happens when the lightning hits this place.
The storm closes in.
Look right there.
Rig 28 takes a direct hit from a lightning strike. And it's blown the main power supply. In the pitch dark, the rig is a dangerous place.
We're trying to figure out what caused it to go down. All I know is I've seen a lot of smoke coming.
As the emergency generator kicks in, tool pusher Freddie Moore is up and out to diagnose the problem.
Danger in it, I mean, happens, you know. That's mechanical out there. You never know when that somebody's gonna give up.
Finally, Freddie solves the problem.
We got the number one generator running. Give a little bit of time, they'll come back on and we'll be back to drilling.
Our little city out here, our lights are coming back on. Everything's gonna be safe again, so we're in good shape.
With the help of their veteran tool pusher, Rig 28 is out of the dark and out of the storm.
Sorry I had to get up so early this morning to take me out there.
A no-show on his last shift.
You don't miss work in the oil field, man.
It just pisses me off that, you know, a mother thing they could take more time to themselves, you know what I'm saying?
Tanks headed to Rig 28 to beg tool pusher Jerry Chansey for his job.
If his mama didn't die, I'm gonna fart.
I missed yesterday, but I had to be there for you.
I just don't want you to catch because of me.
No, baby. It didn't matter what I have to go through for you. If I have to get on my hands and even kiss Jerry's cherry white ass, I'll do it. And try to get this job back.
Hopefully he can have heart and understand. Part of why he was gone was my fault yesterday. I've had a medical issue and I needed him to be there with me.
Why did you get a doctor? Well, I mean, I just wanted to be there.
He's my support system.
They found a spot on my wife's breast. And we had to go for further testing, and I wanted to be there for her. And I know you gave me a second chance, but that's just a family matter.
Well, y'all don't have a cell phone?
Today, we've been married 6 weeks, and now we have 5 kids between us. So this job is very important to both of us, so we can feed our family and pay our bills.
Well, I can understand that, but if you're not out here, you ain't gonna make no money.
Right.
You should have thought of that.
I know.
You know, you got a bigger family. You need to work. You have to. But I can't pay you if you're not here.
Exactly.
I've already wrote you up.
Okay, boss.
And this that you got, I want you to sign it. Okay. Next time you're late, if you don't call me, I will run you off.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sign that for me, please.
Okay. Just really appreciate you giving me another chance.
This is your last chance. I'll give you a chance before.
Right.
Then you need another chance, and this is it.
Okay.
No more.
That's a relief, baby.
I know, thank God.
I better get dressed.
Tank and Jen are going to need plenty of strength. They're waiting for Jen's test results that could be a matter of life and death.
Right here. Lakine. All right, baby. I love you. See you after work. I guess my new religion's coming in handy. Judaism. My newfound strength.
Tank may have smoothed things over with Jerry.
Hey, awesome,
man.
But he's still got to face an angry driller.
Well, I know I should have called.
You got to let me know because I'm your driller, man. If that's the way you see me,
You better call me.
I know you're a family man, and that's why I figured.
I mean, I got kids, and I got a wife, and I can't support them from the house, you know what I'm saying?
I hear you.
This is my job, this is my living, this is my way of life.
Right.
And you're f***ing with my life right now.
Gotcha.
See, now I ain't gonna put over that. I told you that from the beginning.
Yeah, you did.
You better step it up today, because I'm gonna ride your ass all day today. You don't be f***ing me around.
It'll never happen again.
You're saying it right now. It's never gonna happen, man.
Talks a lot. But I mean,
you shake my hand, you tell me that but we'll find out.
Coming up.
Son of a bitch! I bought the shit in my
talking about whooping everybody's ass.
And later.
Is that guy peeing? My yard is not their personal bathroom.
Find out who he is and he's gone. You know,
stupid ass roughneck.
For landowner Peggy Hauser.
Every time I come to the rig, these roughnecks are doing something stupid.
Anytime's a good time to patrol the land where big dogs drill in.
So I'm coming out here today to make sure they're following the rules and doing what they're supposed to be doing. I just want to see if they're as dumb as I think they are. And I bet you they're doing something stupid right now. There's no women around out here. All they do is sit around and play grab ass. I wouldn't doubt it if I catch one of them with their pants down sooner or later. I know Freddie's tired of hearing me bitch about it, but you know what? They're either going to shape up or they're out of here.
On the rig, as the clouds roll in, Hurricane Justin is about to strike.
Mother.
Where's he at?
Brandon's gonna kill me.
We'll be some more, mother. Yeah, I don't know how smart that is to with Brandon like that. I don't think I'd do it.
That fool was retarded.
Without realizing it, Justin messed with something Brandon really cares about.
Damn! Son of a bitch!
I brought mayonnaise up in the top doghouse yesterday and now it's all gone or something.
I ain't got no here quick. I can't even talk around some damn. When a roughneck wants a sandwich, he needs a sandwich. I come out here, I buy to come eat out here. And when I ain't got the damn because some little squirrel wants to go it up, I mean, it's bull. So who's in here?
We ate it all.
How you gonna eat a whole ball of beer with?
It was up in the fridge. Keep it up in the fridge. I guess other hands are eating.
No, you keep it up in the fridge. I bought that for my personal use. I don't mind if you use it. Let me talk. I'm serious. I buy that for us to have when we come to work.
You know how picky I am when it comes to my sandwiches, bro.
I know.
I don't need real mayonnaise.
I couldn't even taste my sandwich, bro.
That's bull, man. When I come out here, I like to have.
I like to have what I want. I don't care. I care for with.
I bought the carry and buy my.
Walking off today.
Well, you picked me up.
Walking, you were
going. You took my Miracle Whip out of my refrigerator.
I'm at your house right now. I'm gonna pick you up.
You gonna learn? I'm gonna teach you right.
Chester's walking home today because the mother f***ed off my Miracle Whip.
Who wants to threaten me about not having a ride home? Well, you ain't the only one out here with a truck or car. Ben will take me right home.
So what's the deal with the Miracle Whip? What'd you do?
I don't know, fool. He's mad because it's all gone. He was sitting in the top doghouse, you know? He wasn't here the other day, so we didn't have the cooler. So I took, you know, the Miracle Whip and the ham and all that stuff up to the top doghouse. Well, I left the Miracle Whip in there.
Man, if you leave it in the fridge for over a day, it's fair game.
And I said, dude, you're arguing about some mayonnaise. I don't like mayonnaise. I like that Miracle Whip. It's the same thing, fool. Yeah, he's pissed off. Now he's all, I gotta ride home alone now. Like, go back on your pits, you big dumb. Huh. You gonna give me a ride home tonight, buddy.
Who? Me or Brandon?
Hey! Don't give that boy a ride home!
God dang.
Don't give him a ride!
Are you still talking about it?
I get it right if you get my damn miracle whip.
The sun came out and you're ruining it.
Get my miracle whip.
You're ruining it. Nice sunshine right now.
And I'll give you the last ride home.
Huh?
But until then, ain't nobody giving you a ride. Unless Jerry does. But ain't nobody on this crew giving you a ride home. Till you get my ball of miracle whip.
God almighty, boy. Talking about whooping everybody's ass out here if they give you a ride home.
You didn't give me a ride home though, right? You
know that he starts coming after my ass.
Coming up.
Is that guy peeing?
Peggy gets pissed.
There's my proof right there. I find out who he is and he's gone.
And later on Black Gold, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. Brandon's threat to leave him stranded.
Cheston's walking home today because my miracle whip.
Has Cheston calling around for a ride home.
Hold on, I'll call you right back, buddy. When I get off of work, I'm going to get a ride home. I ain't going to play that game. My best friend will come pick me up. When they pick me up, we'll have a beer and we'll go home.
You really going to call somebody for a ride?
Bro, when you say something, you mean it, right?
Yeah. Okay, all right, listen, Cheston, right, shut up and let me talk.
Let me talk. You've done enough talking
listen,
to me, man.
Listen. You going to apologize to me or not?
Yeah, I'm sorry, Cole, about your mayonnaise.
What's that like you mean it, dude?
I don't mean that, man. That's
apologize to me, right, Cheston?
I'm sorry. I can't apologize about a can of Miracle Whip, fool. I'm sorry. It just doesn't make logical sense to me. I'm sitting here apologizing about a Miracle Whip bottle. Really? You know how ridiculous that sounds?
Maybe to you.
Let me...
Just look at me in my eyes, bro. Look at me in my eyes.
I want to cry, bro. This is ridiculous.
It ain't no crying matter. Just look at me.
You should be happy you ate a roughneck sandwich today. I'm sorry about your miracle whip.
All right. I'm sorry for...
Threatening me.
We're not giving you right on, but I'll get you right on.
Promise.
I promise.
Put that on your word.
On my word.
All right, well, don't threaten me over...
Oh, don't f*** up my miracle whip, dude.
Man, you don't like it. Man.
It's over with.
It's over with.
No separate cases, man.
Peace is restored, but not for long.
Where's my wrench at? Where's my crescent?
It's in my pocket.
Are you sure? Don't lose my crescent.
I will lie to you.
All right.
I got it.
Golly.
Put a little pep in your step. Quit looking so sad. Next time, will you think about f***ing with my s***?
I wasn't
f***ing, man. Okay, then.
Don't say another word about the miracle whip. Don't say another word. Golly. Worse than a woman.
If Peggy catches the roughnecks breaking the terms of the lease, she can shut down the rig and have them all looking for new jobs.
Now Freddy's gonna hear it. This is I know I didn't just catch that guy peeing. There's my proof right there. These roughnecks aren't housebroken. There's two outhouses right there. My yard is not their personal bathroom. I just pulled up and saw somebody pissing over there.
Well, I can't, you know.
I mean, he couldn't walk 15 foot over to the portable?
Well, I'm not saying that he couldn't, and I'm not saying that he shouldn't, but I know that he didn't, evidently, because you've seen him.
Yeah, find out who he is and he's gone.
Well, roughnecks are like a bunch of children. You know, I do the best I can with what I got, you know. And you can't watch. I got four hands out here. I can't watch them all at the same time.
Well, you find out who it is.
I'll do the best I can, okay?
You find out who it is and take care of it.
Okay. Have a great day, baby.
You too.
Stupid ass roughnecks.
Freddie thought running a tight rig.
Y'all get out here and pick up all the damn trash on the gravel.
Would keep Peggy off his back and give him an edge on the supervisor promotion.
Really? Is that guy peeing?
But there are some things you just can't account for.
You got a bunch of grown men out here, they turn around and they gotta pee. They're not like a bunch of girls have to go to the outhouse to pee. You know? They're just gonna pull their dilly whackers out and they're gonna piss on the ground.
You gonna feel me taking a piss too?
I'll deal with it. I'll find out who it was. Try to make her happy.
While Freddie's worried about keeping Peggy happy,
yeah, hell yeah,
Oscar's worried about keeping the rig from blowing up. 2,000 feet deeper than any previous big dog hole, the Wildcat Well has taken the Roughnecks into unknown and dangerous territory.
It's a good time to run a drill with a fact that, you know, I want all my hands prepared. Just in case, you know, something happens, they know where to go, what to do.
If the Roughnecks hit a pocket of explosive gas, they gotta trigger the blowout preventer, or BOP, by turning a series of valves to trap the gas underground. Any mistake could lead to a deadly explosion.
Make sure that valve's closed. Yeah, don't touch that valve, it's already closed.
We got 3-1s working with, they don't have a clue what's going on. Oss has kind of shown them, you know, the deal with these valves, which one's the open and close.
Well, is it open? I thought we could blow it out.
They still don't know what they're open and closing or what for. I can tell by the look on their face. It don't take but 5 minutes, your rig's gone, dude.
I'm about to blow this horn and find out if my hands know where to go and what to do.
When the horn is blown, it's every Roughneck's responsibility to get to his emergency position. But Tank is hopelessly lost.
Good!
He's having a BOP drill, man.
In a real emergency, Tank's failure to do his job could have cost lives.
Tank, try to listen, but always be ready for that horn. You hear that horn, you run up here no matter what.
Got you.
If you're taking the cut it loose, and come on.
Got it.
But right now, Tank's distracted waiting for his wife's test results.
We found a spot on my wife's breast, and we had to go for further testing, and I wanted to be there for her.
To be honest, I've been going through the motions. I've been having my mind on my wife. It's been crazy, you know, and I've been real, real concerned about it.
Coming up.
I just found the love of my life, and I don't want to see nothing happen to her.
Jen's test results are in. God.
I know you're trying, you just gotta pick up the pace a little bit. He done burned me one time, and I either gonna like to be burned, you know what I'm saying? Get me around, because I'll get rid of you.
4 days ago, Tank was a no-show because of his wife's medical condition.
With my life right now.
But it'll never happen again.
Shake my hand, you tell me that. We'll find out.
You got it.
I worry about the drilling. Y'all worry about making them bite.
Got it.
All right, man.
All right.
Worried about my new bride, you know. Ready to let her go. Man, that's my girl.
But with Oscar pushing to finish this well, he's got no time for a roughneck who doesn't have his head in the game.
Come on, man, help out.
I feel a little bit responsible for the rig being a little bit behind. I mean, I left him shorthanded.
He's a sensitive big fella. Well, Oscar rides our ass, man. Sometimes that's what it takes. I need somebody to ride your ass to get you going. He rides my ass, I'll ride their ass. He rides their ass, they ride my ass. And you know how gay that just sounded?
Pull your head out of your ass! What?
Oh, yo! Hey, pick him up, we need to hurry, hurry! Come on, let's go! Come on!
These are roughnecks, there's not a lot of heart out here as far as... I mean, there's heart for, like, work and stuff, but as far as empathy, you know, there's not a lot of it.
As Tank's wife, Jen, drives onto the rig, he knows she could be bringing bad news.
I just found the love of my life, and I don't want to see nothing happen to her.
It's fine.
Oh, baby.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Baby, everything's fine. All my tests were negative.
Oh, honey. Oh, honey, I'm so happy.
I know, me too.
We have to go to Santa Cruz.
I know.
Thank God. Oh, my God. I've never been a religious person, and I think definitely this is, God up there saying, hey, I'm up here, you know? And, you know, we said prayers this morning, and prayers do work. Win, lose, or draw, man. If anything was going to happen, we were going to tackle it head on.
I love you.
I love you better more than anything in this world.
I love you more than anything in this world. I needed to come out and tell him that everything was okay. He's everything in the world to me. So to know that he could put his mind at ease and get back to work and focus on that is everything. And I needed to see him, and I think vice versa, to see that my face and his face, that everything's okay.
Open him up, don't wait! Come on! Up! Come on, Tanner!
All Tanner's motivated today, you know, he's gonna work. His old lady thinking he had cancer, but, you know, it turns out she didn't, so that's good, you know, knowing that. You know, he's a family man, so, you know, I'm a family man. I understand where he's coming from.
Damn!
Next week on Black Gold.
Stop throwing sacks at me, ho!
Justin's mad as hell.
By yourself, dude.
Well, then get the out of here!
And he's not taking it anymore.
Somebody needs to put a chain on him.
I'll make you not visible on this rig.
And later, it's all-out war in West Texas.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
It's original.